let's get ready for the Rumble
well,
here.
What about this matchup here? I think that there is a favorite team. It would be Akkaren.
Yeah, I played with Switzerland the last 2 years, but we are quite familiar with the strength of such teams. I think the Swiss team, they brought some not well experienced players here, but this was the idea they had. They want to bring the players here to learn and to try out. This is what they're probably going to do now. So we see here, for example, in the blue jersey, it's Marius. He will be probably one of the key players. We've seen him in the first match already. He's going to take... Oh, no, he has a fast break now. Very nice. But this is Matthias here trying to attack from the closed side.
They had the goalie off there.
Chance. Yeah.
Partially.
Of course, this is what they tried now, to just get fast and just to try out what's be possible. And but we see here lately the reach here and massive defense, but playing the ball quite nice. It must be Sebastian.
Nice,
43.
Good play.
This is Kavavsky passing to Matthias. And so far, Switzerland is starting not bad in this game. So they're having the ball, playing a bit of the ball around. It must be Dominic here with number 18 here, trying to get in position for the pass.
Yeah, they've got a player underneath the scrum. And so you've actually, as far as Marius Bunis goes, he's been the coach on the other side of the pool from you.
Yeah.
When he was coach both of the women and men for the junior championships.
Marius, yeah, he did it in the past. He did it not.
He's not now. He's done.
Yeah. Currently, he's changed. He forwarded this job to, or he passed it to Tort.
Yep.
He's also a well-known player from the national team, and he played also with... I don't know which team is originally to Boplin, or where he's played for.
Where did he start out?
So we have also some fans in the chat. If you have any questions or any comments, please don't hesitate to write something down. So far, we are quite impressed of the Swiss gameplay here. They're really trying to play aggressive. They don't want to be here the clear loser. We were giving a favor at the beginning to Akkaren. Let's see if they can handle it and manage it. You see Marius here with the blue shirt. He's quite a good visible player with the number 11. This is maybe one of the key players we're going to see more often in the game, because he's probably the player making the blocks, making the positioning and the opponent goal. So far, Akkaren was not able to get on the opponent side, so maybe there's a chance. First really good chance now, maybe
long
Akkaren
pass.
Having a fast break.
Nice pass.
That's good. He's alone with the goalkeeper. Daniel Yusin is trying to defend. Yeah. And it is in.
That was clinical.
Very, very well done. Daniel Yusin from Switzerland was not able to stop the Norwegian attacker. Unfortunately, we could not see the number. Did you see any number?
No, but clearly the long pass that we thought maybe, okay, is he going to get it? He swam, he got it, and that led him to the goal even
that
faster.
That was a key factor, yeah. Even this was a nice thing here.
No back was able to get down and defend the goal.
This was awesome, yeah. So
he was underneath the goalie.
You see from the half deep of the pool.
Yeah.
They got the pass. It was more or less a blind pass in the swimming way. He could take it on and just go forward and
I wouldn't say it was a blind pass, but it was a very he threw it out very
That's
much
it.
With a long lead,
so
that
the
swimmer
needs to start to swim in, yeah. Catch the ball. This is what you usually do, what you know from football, or even the Colombian and the Norwegian national team, and even Molde.
Like
I'm very familiar, famous for that.
An alley-oop pass in basketball.
Yeah. Now you see here the Swiss team are really nice defending here. We talked before the match about what is maybe important against Akkaren. I try to recommend them that you need to play, you need to sit really close to the basket, they don't give them any space, because this is what they want to do. So far, they gave them a great space with this counter-attack Akkaren could do here, and there's maybe a next one. You see Marius here, with the number 11, passing forward.
No,
this one with the yellow stripes, I see this guy scored the first one,
too many,
and now is assisting the second goal.
Too many people around the goal there.
Yeah.
They had both sides and the center. And how are you going to defend your basket if you've got three players there, all of whom can get the ball, the goalie doesn't know where it's coming from?
That's it. So Zürich started quite good in this match, but now there were two really fast goals made by Akkaren. Do you think the game is already decided, Daryl?
Well, I don't think Zurich can win, but I like the play. I think they played well.
They're playing not really scared. Like, they're just trying out. They're just swimming around. But this kind of ball uses are very, very dangerous. Like, you see here how fast. So Akkaren, they're always ready for the counterattack. Now you have here. You have a call from the referees. It's hitting.
I think one point to make about that fast break there is that one player from Akkaren was swimming, and that meant that three players had to panic swim to catch up, and they will lose some energy from having been in that situation. So the Akkaren guy, he also generates some lactic acid maybe, but not to the same degree as the players who were panicking. And over the course of a match and a weekend, that will start to wear your team down if you have to do a lot of rescue like that. Yeah.
So far, so when the Swiss team is in ball possession, they're doing this quite good. So the effort putting by Akkaren, getting the ball in the corner is not that. Oh, there's a nice chance now.
Chance.
Really, there was the defender tried to get the ball and he left the basket. He didn't catch the ball or caught the ball probably, and so he lost it immediately to a Swiss player who could attack. Fortunately for Akkaren, it doesn't turn to a goal, but so far maybe it would be probably the best chance Swiss had so far. But on the other side now, here's Daniel Yusin again, and there's a volley goal. Whoa! This was very close, guys.
That was a long shot.
He dropped it on the ring. Now there's Daniel Yusin again, maybe there's a shoulder in the basket. Yeah. Oh, but he gave it forward. Yeah. Favor, but this was very well made by Akkaren. They had a really good chance here. It was like swimming over the goalkeeper who made it more or less a classic position. But the goalkeeper is often the strategy what teams are doing. So if the goalkeeper is alone in the basket, they need to know, do I stay as a goalkeeper or maybe do I leave my
to go into the back position.
Yeah, to go to a more classic defending style position. This was now here chosen by the goalkeeper.
To stay on the basket.
Daniel, he went down, tried to defend with his feet. Their attacker jumped up, swimming up, and he tried throwing the ball into the basket. He just hit the ring, but was quite close.
It was close.
Could be also
well, we heard everybody who was watching it on the live stream here go, oh, they were.
It was very close then. But on the other hand, it's quite amazing to see that even the ball got lost immediately. A Norwegian player picked the ball up and started the second wave. And with the second wave, the defender was missing. Here we see Marius. Awesome! Very good attack. Have you seen that?
Yeah.
This was awesome. With both hands, he catched the ball. And then with the ball, he hit the head of the goalkeeper and were rising him up. He could not drop it because maybe I've seen that the goalkeeper could touch the ball with his hands while he was pumped up. But this was a very good technique. And this Marius is a very physical player.
Bunis is a national team player.
Yeah, a very physical, compact player. We see a very strong and very professional technique here. And this was quite impressive. It's a busy, it isn't quite in. Because usually you just need a small spot to score. But in this case, he already lifted the entire goalkeeper up for centimeters. You know, what is quite abnormal.
Well, part of the problem is that usually it should be the direction that the person attacking the goal is moving away from the goal, then they have to shoot back. And
here you can see Christian Schaefer passing the ball through. Now the ball still is in the possession of this was very good. And there's a double pass. Maybe he brings the ball back. Very good scene here, but this was good. Here's Daniel Yusin, the goalkeeper, now here trying not to go into the goal, but defending. All right, now the referee comes to the surface. I don't know if he's seen a foul. Well, this was a very risk situation. We can see Marius. Now he's stealing the basket. But it was Daniel Yusin, with this white player with the shirt, who's normally the goalkeeper, who has decided not to go on the basket, but attacking him immediately. The attacker. Now we see two Norwegian players. They've stolen even the goal and the defending position, and they didn't make it. Unfortunately, oh my God, this is a pity, you know. No, in the second wave they did. Oh, that was crazy. Too many, two players, you know?
Yeah, well.
That was crazy, two players. There were three, two players with the ball.
Again, the stolen basket. Not only did they score a goal,
yep.
But the stress level went way up for the for Zurich, and they're for sure now, they have lost whatever calm they had.
Now we have the halftime. So you can see here.
Four points. Can they make that up? Very hard.
I think the issue is, Akkaren is very well experienced. You know, with a 4-0 lead going in the halftime, like, it's very comfortable. You know, the thing will be, the question is, what wants Zurich? Do they want to say, okay, we lost, let's keep the 4-0 and concentrate on the defense? Or are they saying, don't give a fuck about how many goals we're getting, we want to show all the world that we are able to score? Because they are playing against a team with a very, very nice defense. At least they had one chance, but it was occurred by a mistake of Norwegian. So it was a situation where the defender lost the basket, tried to catch the ball and missed it. So a Swiss player could immediately attack the basket without a proper positionated, with a proper defender in position. Now we see with the 84 front routine here, going to in the halftime, going to his players now. He was the captain in the last 2 years. He passed this position to Piccolo, who is now in the water here, talking to his team. The white shirt, we can see Daniel Jussen with the number 13. Maybe to give you some names, it's Martin Wernle. This is the guy with the red stripes. We see number 7. Matthias Dufour here with the back and the blue snorkel. On the other side, we see the Akkaren team, very relaxed. Or this looks like a very relaxed halftime speech, doesn't it?
Is that Christian Schaefer?
Yeah, on the other side, yeah. We have Christian Schaefer, the big tall one, in the middle talking right now. But they look very relaxed. You know, some people are sitting there, even with. Yeah. I don't know if they're even listening. It's crazy.
Yeah. Well, Christian Schaefer can be very. He demands that his teammates step it up. Yeah, but they don't have a problem.
I think so far the Akkaren needs to prepare for Akkaren, because this is the team they're playing. Then later, it will be who will win in the group. And of course, it's very, very comfortable here to be first in the group, because the second of this, I don't know, really not really sure, but you have. You know, older the first in the group is playing against the second of the other group.
Yes.
And you have strong teams dominated by one group by Bamberg, another group by Malmö, another group dominated here maybe by Orcas or Akkaren. So every team, whoever is getting second, will receive a very strong team of one of the other groups. So it's always comfortable.
It
so
pays,
the game later,
pays to win group. Yeah.
Orcas against Akkaren will be a very very important match for both teams. So far for Akkaren, it's quite important here now to get in, to wake up, to get in shape, to get this feeling for the ball, for the scoring. In Zurich, at least, they need to prepare right now for the Australian team, Wales, what they're going to later today. So Zurich playing back in the match now. We have here blue Akkaren, white the Swiss team from Zurich. And we are again in the midfield, but now with the better ending for Akkaren. Akkaren is starting, having the ball. Very nice pass. Have you seen it? This was very nice done by this player. Who scored
over to the safe side there.
Who scored already the 1-0 and assisted the 2-0. He made now also an awesome assist here. Unfortunately, could not see his number, but this one with the red stripes is very significant here in this game. So we see a referee call from the desk referee, who is Lars from Denmark. So Lars from Denmark, the deck referee here, has seen any issue, and now they want to make a fast start, but referee stopped it again. So there's a 3-throw in favor for Switzerland. Let's see if they can come back to the game. So far they passed and they lost the ball. What is the pity here? Switzerland is not. In this situation, with all mistakes of Akkaren, Switzerland is not really able to get very close to the basket.
Oh.
On the other hand, you see here very dangerous situation, very good attacks. But here you see Matthias with the number 7, who really cleared the situation, but now that Beth, the defender position was stolen, he with a block, but this is a bit pushing in my opinion.
Another score.
Yeah, it was another well done. I'm not really sure if this action from the player who's taking the defender position was really that passive. But for the both referees in the water, Robert and Manuel, it seems to be all right and okay. So they were giving the goal, and it's so that is just what it is.
Well, the other thing is it doesn't really pay off for Akkaren to get more and more goals. Goal difference doesn't make much of a difference in Champions Cup.
So guys, I'm checking the live chat, and I'm wondering, do we have here any fans for Akkaren or for Switzerland? Make some noise, tipping some in some comments. Show your teams that you're supporting them, please. So I'm going to take this in our conversations. If you have any input for us. We see here now, after the goal from Akkaren, is a 5-0. Very comfortable lead. So
yeah, they don't need.
We have Switzerland now here with Hannes Plüsch now with the number 10. Passing. Frank Trittin is having here the ball. Passes through Dominic here with number 13 is in position. Now we see Marius in blue on the basket. But yeah, everything is all right so far. Pass to Akkaren. Akkaren, they're so fast and getting through now. 2-1 situation.
Oh,
he lost the ball. Awesome. Unbelievable. That's a pity.
Oh,
he
wow.
He really made it massive. Have you seen that?
He got the goalie off and shot
they
it
got at him. Two players, they attacked the goalkeeper. He passed through. It was an awesome, nice pass. But then the attacker, he lost the control for the ball. He dropped up. He caught it. And then in the second wave, he did lifting the goalkeeper and pushing the ball in. Awesome technique.
Yeah, he didn't float up. He stayed close.
He stayed close to the basket, even he was raising the hand and not even moving with his body towards the ball. He was just keeping his body in position, just raising the arm to bringing the ball back to him, to having still a good. Here you see Marius now with the attack.
Oh,
he tried, but have you seen that? He attacked and immediately he made the pass in the same move. This was also a great technique. Now we send here some supporters for the Zurich team. That's great, nice. So we have Corbin Dollars, we have Angela Niederer supporting the Swiss team, and we have Libby, who's also supporting the Swiss team, and Maximilian Rapp. Thank you for your support, but where are the Akkaren supporters? I've not seen any Akkaren supporters in the live chat so far. So you're so focused in the match, or you're not even watching? But so far, it's a very well-dominated match by Akkaren. They're really making a good job. Can you see this? So it's
it's
very clear.
It's very important that...
If we have here any supporter from Akkaren, can you tell me who's this guy with the red straps at his mask? Because he's very significant here. He made the first, he made the 1-0, assisted the second and the third goal. And here we have another one, 7-0. I think Swiss is now broken, you know, mentally, unfortunately. So it's like they made a good game at the beginning.
In the beginning.
They had the ball, they could play, and but now they're...
Both on offense and defense.
Yeah, they're taking all timeout. No, Akkaren is taking the timeout. Not even Swiss. Not even Zurich is taking it.
No. Underwater rugby in Switzerland is...
So I see here Jesper Hasslund, the first supporter for Akkaren with Go Akkaren, yeah? I can see it's quite good so far what Akkaren is doing here in the water. So there's Swiss did not even had they just had this one chance given by Akkaren, but this mistake of the defender, all the other situation they could clear far away from the basket. So for the Swiss team there was not really one good chance. It was just Matthias one time when he attacked from above. But this was not very, very close because Marius was lying on the basket and he looked very relaxed. Even not raising his arms, he put his arms very relaxed on his body and just kept the player away with his legs. So everything here, very controlled situation by Akkaren. They're playing here very seriously, very professional. Zurich, of course, is trying here to keep up, to stay here and to try to play here the best. I've talked with the captain Piccolo, he said to us, even don't matter what you're doing wrong, just try out. This is a game for us to try out here against the best teams. It's about to find us. We've never played that professional together on that high level, just in training. For example, we never had that pressure at our basket. So try out how you feel and how you can play each other. This was well defended by Daniel Yusin here, but the second attack from Marius. And Marius scored here. Very well done. Very well done, Marius.
It was like
the technique is quite good.
It was like a drill in practice. Do it like this, and he did it.
We have, for example, this was especially who has joined yesterday the Underwater Rugby Academy. Samuel from the Yorkers, he told us about his philosophy in scoring and his analysis of biomechanics.
Yeah, I heard
and
about
this was, for example, especially the technique he told.
Here they come again.
Keeping the head. The head must be at the ball side. There's another one. Made by the captain again, Daniel Yusin.
The ball must be at the head side. He prefers there.
Yeah, though he said that, for example, when we remember the goal from Marius, your head needs to be at the side where the wall is and not on be on the open side. So this is what Marius did. He had the head on his right shoulder while he was attacking from the right side. So he could bring more pressure to the goalkeeper, and it's not pushing the goalkeeper with his head against the wall, but away from the wall. So this is in terms of vectors, it's a more efficient way to bring pressure and to push the goalkeeper. But so far this was also a very nice technique. I've seen it from the captain. He were pushing the goalkeeper with one hand, and while he was with the other, all immediately trying to score. But there was the attacker, it was Frank Turchin, immediately defended and wrestled or cleared the situation.
Timing is everything in that.
Yeah, but now the referee gives a warning for the blue team or maybe even a time penalty, because you have seen the situation when Frank Turchin get in the wrestling situation, the Norwegian player were trying to get free, very, very ambitious, and therefore he also had with the elbow. So with the elbow he
roughing.
Yeah, he caught a very, very dangerous situation. I know, even if it's underwater, if you get a hit, a very hard hit from an elbow, this could be very, very dangerous.
If it hit them in the liver, liver shock.
So we have here two very well experienced referees with Manuel and Robert, and they have a really clear, we have a clear feeling here.
So is there a penalty?
Count the players. Yeah, see, just see five players in the water. Do you see a sixth one? No. They probably really have a time penalty. This is my assumption. So yeah, just see five players in the water. That's it. So there's a power play for the Swiss team. That's the reason they're pushing right now so hard. So there's Sebastian passing the ball through to Piccolo. Piccolo's trying here now to attack. It takes immediately the goalkeeper. On the other hand, now, what is it? Is this a chance? Frank Turchin here in white also was in the open side, but he has not received the ball. And they lost it. Well done by Akkaren. This was a very good scene from the Swiss team, but Akkaren, they're very, very nice in defending.
Yes, so the Swiss play in some Central European cups, and is there a league now?
So we know that the guy with the red straps from Akkaren is Menneken Eamano. So Menneken Eamano, hands up, you made a really nice match here from the very beginning, with your first goal and your two assists. You made very professional here. So a very amazing game of this guy. But even Marius here made a sign that he is one of the top scorers here at the tournament. So he made, you can say, 3 out of 4 chances he scored, and one he immediately made an assist for another player.
He's a real competitor.
Yeah.
And he
was a very, very nice dance now.
Did you play against him in junior?
I don't think that he played junior. I cannot remember him. I played in the years with Iver Bjørnerem, and later with his brother. I remember Iver especially because he's the same age as I am. We played 2005, 6 and 7 in the junior national teams, and we even met in the water. Yeah, this was the most significant players then, and I'm not sure if Marius really played juniors.
Well, is it halftime?
So this is the game is over
game's
so far.
Sorry, that's the end.
Game is over, and we can say this was a very nice match from Akkaren, which is winning here 9-0 against
rather
the team
easily
from Switzerland, Zurich.
And what do we have next?
Zurich started very nice in this match, made a lot of effort, had more ball possession in, but the experience led Akkaren here to a, yeah, you can say, very, very clear 9-0. They just had, even when they played in under, even when they played with five players, so that even when Swiss had the power play, they not occurred any dangerous situation. So very professional, very well done here.
We'll be going, we have matches all the way to 9:30.
Yeah.
So I'm going to take a break now.
No, well, it's no problem, yeah. So we go, heading over to now the next female match. What is also quite interesting because it's a night of kind of neighborhood challenge. We see the team from Austria, which is Vienna, playing against the team from Zurich. And you know, there's a certain history.
They know each other, yeah.
Both language, German-speaking countries. So it's like the two small countries, you know, neighbors. And let's see this.
I'm going to take a short break.
Yeah, no problem. All right. See you later, everyone. So we're going here now to prepare ourselves for the next match. It will be the women match from Vienna against Helvetia from Zurich. And we have several referees here, even in the water. I want to introduce you to referees. What will be Manfred from Germany. He's the deck referee. We can see Raphael from Sweden underwater, and we see also Bob from Germany underwater on the one side. So let's get ready for this match. Try to find the team lists so I can introduce you some numbers. If you don't, if you want to join, even my, if you also want to read the team list, you can find them on the champion.